Welcome to VCG Knowledge Channel. To get notification of all new videos, please subscribe our channel and also like our videos. Welcome friends. Hello friends. Welcome to Microsoft Excel. Hello friends. Welcome to a series of Microsoft Learning. In this video, we are going to learn how we can create graphs from data table in Excel and formatting part. Okay, so let's start. So as you can see, data table on my screen. So we wanted to generate one graph. Okay, so I will start with very basic thing, how we can create a simple graph. Okay, so I have selected student name. These are the student name. Okay, class 1. So I have selected student name header and student name. At the same time, just click on, keep pressing shift, or just select this 25 and then press control and select this match marks. Okay, repeating, first select student name, then press control and match marks. Okay, so we have selected a student name and match marks. Go to insert, and then you can see recommended chart, bar chart, line chart, pie chart, and different types of chart are there. Okay, so just click on anything, maybe bar chart 2D, or you can click on more column, or if you click here, just don't click, just put a cursor here. You can see different type of charts are coming. Okay, you can see, click on more column charts, so you can see big picture. Whatever you could see here, you can see all the combination here. Click on column, you can see how this column will look like, how see line will look like, pie chart, bar chart, area, XY scattered, stock, surface, radar. Okay, so I'm first going with the column. You can select a color one or single color. So I'm going with the single color first. So now the chart has been created. Simple chart. I have taken a simple chart, only one range of maths. Okay. Now you can see on one side, on an axis X, you can see the student name, and here marks achieved in maths. Okay, now how we can do formatting? So just click here again. You can see I have put a cursor here and then click again. You can see plus sign is here. Click here, you can see data labels. You can see the data labels has come now. Again, if you click here, where you wanted to show this data, at center, it is showing at center, inside end, inside base, outside end, or data, call it, for which student you want to see, or more options, you can see here. So as per your requirement, you can select this. Okay, so I'm going with the outside end. Okay, now you can see axis title. So axis title has come. You can see here I am removed this. Again, you can set the position where you wanted to see, primary horizontal or primary vertical. Click here and you can edit student name. Okay, again click here, which data? If you want to see the data table, you can see the data table has come. Okay. Then we have error bars. We don't want to show anything. These are the basic. We have axis titles. We have already selected chart title. We have chart title. We have removed, or we can switch it on or off. Okay. Data tables. We have seen labels and data tables blue. Okay. And we can also set the position. Okay. So we can switch it on or off this information. Now formatting. If you want to make it bold or change font, you just click here. You can change the font. Okay. Or if you want to rename, you can rename it. Maths score. Okay. You see this is bold and this is unbold. So again, you can do one thing. You can go select this, go to bold. Want to increase the size, you can increase the size, student name. Okay, same thing you can do with the access title. Make it bold. Okay, if you want to color it, color it. I want to change this data, name of this access. Score. Okay, I want to change the color here. You can change the color. The student name, you can change the color of this as well. Let's take this green one. Okay, you can make it big or larger. As you can see, you can also just click on any of this and click on bold. Everything is bold. And if you want to increase the size, increase the size. If you want to select the color, you can select the color here. Right? So this way we can do the formatting. Okay. One more thing. If you don't want to show this, just click here, line. Small lines, grids. You can see this is selected. These are just delete them from keyboard. So this is neat and clean. If you want to select this data table, now selected, you can see this, you can make it bold, right? If you want to color it, color it, or no fill. Okay, now I want to change the background color and the border as well. Okay, so how we can do this? Right click, you can see two options are there. Fill an outline, you can select the outline, black color, you can see. Black color. If you want to change the thickness, you can change the thickness. Okay. Make it blue. Now I want to fill the color. Let's say I wanted to see this one. You can see this. Or you can make it bold this range as well. Again. So this way we can create a chart and do the formatting. I have taken a very simple example with the one series only. One series, like I have selected the student and maths. If you wanted to change the chart type, just right click here on the chart, change the chart type. Line, select line, okay. You can see line type. Okay. Again, if you want to change to any other type, you can select bar chart this way. Even though within column, this is two dimensional. If you wanted to see this way, 3D cluster, you can see, or this way. Okay, again you can reposition it. Click here, data labels, data callout, more options. where you wanted to show this. You can select the separators and numbers. Okay, you can do the formatting. If you wanted to create a graph with two series or more than one, so I'm selecting a student name here and then select, keep pressing control, select all this up to 25. Again, go back, insert, click here, custom. Okay, column. I want to see column here. Okay. Now you can see because there are six subjects and there are 25 students. So for each student, you can see the graph for each subject. Maths, English, Hindi, EVS, ICT, third language. Again, you can select the formatting part. You can show the labels here. Okay. Now, I want to switch on or off data. Which subject I want to see. So presently you can see it is on for each and every subject, right? If I remove any of them, let's say third. So this language, third language option should go, right? It has gone. Okay, you can increase the size this way. Reduce. Okay, again right click, select data. I wanted to see only for two subject or three subject. Okay, now you can see the graph. So this way you can create graphs and you can do the formatting. You can change the background color, you can change the font color, font size, okay, make it bold. You can remove the these grid lines if you don't want, just select it, remove it. You can change the background color, right? You can make the, you can color the border and change the thickness. Okay, presently you can see there are three colors are there. Click on this option, color. If you just select here, if you can see the different color range, right? If you want this color range will be there. If you want to just single color and different shades, you can go this way. So this way you can do the formatting as per your requirement, whatever suits you. Okay, so this way we can create graphs. And okay, if you have any question, please comment on the comment section and subscribe my channel. Thank you.